What's up, guys? My name is Sankas, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to make another sound in Serum. So let's go and get started. We're going to go to the Spectral folder over here. We're going to go ahead and select Trilobite 3 by Seamless. Sounds something like this. Let's go ahead and bring that down into bass range here. Turn it up a bit. So here we have this nice kind of squelchy sound, and has a lot of cool characteristics in this. Very robotic sounding, so let's go ahead and bring an LFO on this wavetable position here. Something like that, and let's go ahead and just bring this curve down a little bit, or draw some points in here and try to get an interesting movement out of this wavetable position. Maybe something like that. And to have some more interesting movement in this wavetable or in this first oscillator, let's go ahead and modulate the level here separately with a separate LFO from the wavetable position. You can get a more wobbly kind of sound out of it by having a different modulation. Let's go ahead and sync this up to the same speed and make sure it's both triggered. So we already get a kind of cool sound out of this. Let's go ahead and thicken it up with the unison, giving it some stereo information here and detuning it just a little bit. And I'm going to go ahead and send in the sub as well to make it nice and strong. Now I want the sub to kind of sustain on this sound, but I don't want that sub to kick in with that attack, since this sound doesn't have much of an attack. It's very smooth and rounded off in terms of the level shape here. So let's go ahead and use an envelope and bring the attack up a bit so it kind of fades into the sound. That's a bit smoother, feels a bit more natural like that. Let's go ahead and take oscillator B here and bring the good old bend minus on, which kind of does this thing here. Just bends the saw wave a little bit. We're going to keep it at zero. We're going to take this first LFO, bring it on the bend as well, so we get it, modulating the warping shape of this bend minus as well in the same kind of pattern as the wavetable position here. Gonna bring the level down, as it will mainly just be modulated with this LFO a little bit here, but its main purpose is to send an FM signal to the oscillator A over here. Gonna use a little bit of this one, but I'm just gonna mix them in slightly. So that thickens it out a bit and adds some interesting saw harmonics into this sound. Now let's go and take LFO 3, and we're going to bring the FM warping knob up a little bit, and take LFO 3 and just apply it a tad bit, and send this to 1 over 2, and trigger it as well. So now we get this nice movement on top of that that consistent wobble, that wow wow. Now we get a nice little variation to the sound where it goes wow, it kind of, goes back and forward and evolves over time a little bit. So that makes it a bit more interesting. Let's go ahead and make sure that oscillator B is going into the filter as well, and let's engage this filter. So of course default it's on a high pass. Let's go ahead and change that to a high pass peak 12. So this is the high pass filter with a built-in peak over here. We can get some nice and interesting vowel characteristics out of the sound. Gonna go ahead and apply the LFO 2 to the filter cutoff here. I want to make sure that it's in bipolar mode instead of unipolar. So instead of just going into positive, I want to make sure it goes into positive and negative as well. So let's go into our matrix here. And entering the matrix, gonna click this arrow thing here. So now we will be into bipolar mode. Already makes a huge difference to the sound. Let's go ahead and modulate the frequency knob as well in the opposite direction in unipolar mode, just going into negative. So that's cool, giving it a bit of more vowel-y movement and stuff. We can also modulate the mix of the sound. And just kind of fade in the peak or the filter with this the same LFO here. So what we can do here as well is take this third LFO, which is giving that evolving movement, that variation to this sound. We can go ahead and take this and not bring it on the resonance, but bring it on the cutoff and bring it down a bit, just a tiny bit, to give a bit of variation in the filter movement as well. Cool, now let's go to our hyperdimension expansion in our effects section, bring the mix down of the hyper section here, and in the dimension section, let's go and bring the size to around a quarter, and let's bring this first LFO here into the mix and bring it up a little less than halfway, and same with the mix on the dimension section, just a little less. Now we get the sound kind of more in a room and feels a bit spacier. It's hard to tell since we already have this unison cranked up here. You can hear the difference more without the unison. So this kind of accentuates that effect that we already have. Moving on to the distortion, I'm going to use a bit of soft clipping, which is not as harsh as the tube distortion. This just does a bit of soft clipping, so if you can imagine what clipping is, it kind of saturates it in the same kind of fashion. So gonna go ahead and crank up the drive almost all the way, and we get a bit of more bite to our sound with this. So moving on to the chorus, let's go ahead and bring the hertz rate up here a bit. And we're going to mix the mix in as well. We're going to mix the chorus effect in as well, this time with LFO 2. This one is a bit smoother, so it will kind of fade in more rather than coming in very strong and then fading out. So just kind of mixing it in a little bit. And gonna go and add some compression as well. Not in multiband mode, because in my opinion, we have a lot of highs here already, and this is gonna make it very, very, almost too bright on the top, in my opinion. So let's go and bring the threshold down a little bit. Just kind of squeeze the sound a little bit. Right around there, just kind of compressing the top and give it a bit of makeup gain. So we're just kind of squishing the sound a little bit here. And I'm going to go to our EQ as well. Going to go ahead and send both of these to peak mode and bring one of them up and the other one down. Maybe decreasing the Q a little bit here. And I'm going to modulate the frequency with LFO2 in opposite directions with these frequency knobs here. So we're going to want to make sure we don't have the gain up too high here and have this happening nice and low. I usually tend to shoot for the around 200 to 300 hertz range, so this will start a little over 100 and sweep through those areas. And last but not least, this filter is going to serve as a bit of a cleanup to kind of shape the sound even further. Let's go ahead and take LFO2 and just bring it right on the cutoff, and we can maybe bring the cutoff knob up a bit and adjust it to our taste. Something like that. So let's do a little bit of adjusting here still. Let's go ahead and mess around with this FM knob here now that we have the effects all set up. And we're going to keep this on zero. I'm just going to bring the FM knob down all the way and have this LFO3 sort of adding that variation part to the sound. makes a bigger difference when it's on the bottom and it sounds a bit cleaner, and we still get some of that saw here. And to remove that, of course, we can just take the level down. Personally, want to have it in there just a little bit, just to kind of thicken the sound up a bit, but not too much so it doesn't kind of take over the sound here. And that's pretty much the sound here. A couple of things we can do to kind of or make the sound even better or more versatile is engage the mono legato down here, of course, so we can have the slide notes when we overlap notes. And we can also hit always, so we don't have to overlap notes to get those slides. And this kind of sound usually sounds great when being used with those kind of quick bends and short bends, kind of adding some more movement into the sound by just bending it around a bit from note to note. So that's just me hitting two different notes, going from F, C sharp to F. And that's usually how I hear these kinds of sounds being used. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And with that being said, I hope you guys have a great day.